Hello, my name is Inisha, and in this short video, I will show you a few of the workflow techniques that were passed down to me from some of the best animators in the industry. This video is mainly for advanced spine users who want to work faster and smarter. Often we're required to produce animation quickly, and may be forced to put out work we aren't 100% happy with. By choosing the right workflows, you can avoid that and create high quality animations in very little time. To help doing that, we've added a special tool to Spine's new graph that soon you will grow to love as much as I do. It's called the Favor tool. To understand this tool better, I have to wind back the animation clock. For nearly 100 years, 2D animators have been using a method of numbering their drawings to record their timing. This little timing chart indicates the timing and the spacing for an animation. When animating pose to pose, after you establish the main poses for your scene, the next step is to add breakdown poses. Breakdowns are what makes the animation interesting, providing overlap, delay of different parts, personality, and more. The Favor tool helps you to create a breakdown pose that favors the previous key or the next key. To give you an example, here I made a dash animation for Spine Boy. I used the classic pose-to-pose workflow technique, where you create your main poses first. For now, I keyed all the properties for each pose. Later, when I'm all done animating, I will use animation cleanup to delete the extra keys. Note that this is not a tutorial on how to make a dash animation. Some dashes have anticipation, some don't, depending on your gameplay requirements. This dash is just an example to show how to use the Favor tool. So we have our idle pose, then anticipation pose, flying, landing, and overshoot poses, and then we settle back into the idle pose. With just these main poses, this animation is quite dull because it's so linear. In every transition, everything moves together. To fix this, what we need are good breakdown poses. What is a breakdown pose and how is it different from the other poses? Look at it this way. A breakdown is an intermediate pose. It doesn't work by itself. It needs the main poses to explain the action. The breakdown adds interest to the basic movements and greatly improves the quality of the animation. Another way to think of this is that your main poses are describing what is happening. In this case, Spine Boy is going from an idle pose to an anticipation pose. The breakdown pose is telling how it is happening, meaning what parts of the body will move first, how far, in what direction, and so on. This is where the Favor tool comes into play. I can go to the frame where I want a breakdown pose and drag the Favor slider to create a new key and choose if it should be more like the previous key or the next key. This is much easier than creating the breakdown pose manually. Then I only need to make a few adjustments to customize the pose, and it's done. It's good practice to observe yourself working to identify functions you use often. Then use hotkeys rather than moving the mouse, clicking and moving back. You want to work smart. You will see that I use hotkeys for most common actions because it's much faster. For example, I often jump from key to key and from frame to frame. I rarely scrub the timeline position because I find it slows me down. If I do want to scrub, we have a new hotkey that allows you to scrub anywhere in Spine. It's called Timeline Frame Drag. There are a few similar hotkeys you can experiment with to find what you like best. Back to our breakdowns. I want Spine Boy to lead the action with his hips. So I'll favor the hips to be more like the next key. The leg is just starting to move, and I want to ease it out of the idle pose. So I'll favor the foot to be more like the previous key. Now I'll adjust a few other parts to finish up the breakdown pose. And that's it. The breakdown is done. Now let's put breakdown keys on frame 5. I will favor the hips towards the previous key, as I want his back leg to stay in contact with the ground to give the feeling that he's pushing off. That means the whole pose needs to be closer to the anticipation key. To do that, again, I use the Favor tool. I'll also adjust the hips a bit for a nicer arc and adjust the other parts accordingly. For the rest of the video, I'll use hotkeys to move the favor slider, because it's much faster. Next, we'll jump to frame 6. I want to favor the hips toward the next key, but since there is a huge distance between the keys, I can make a smear frame that stretches Spine Boy way out of proportion. Okay, before we play our animation and see what we've got, I want to first share another helpful tip. It's very common to want to play part of your animation, so you press play, then stop, then you need to drag the timeline position back to where you started. That is very slow, so to help with this, we have improved the playback hotkeys. When playing forward, if you press play backward, playback stops and the timeline position jumps back to the frame you started on. So if you're working on a long animation and you want to preview part of it, just press D, then A, and the timeline is back at the frame you were working on. Now I will add the rest of the breakdown poses. You can see that in my first pass, I still have all the keys set to linear, and I didn't touch the dope sheet or graph at all yet. That's the idea. The favor tool helps me to make the breakdowns very quickly, and by using a lot of hotkeys, I can have fun and think only about the animation. Now that we have our breakdowns in, it's time to polish this animation. It's important to polish your curves by following the bone hierarchy. By this, I mean don't make nice arcs with the hand if you haven't polished the hips first. This is because the hip's movement will influence its child bones, so always start with the rootmost bones in the hierarchy. Now I will change the linear curves to Bezier to improve the spacing, working mainly in the graph to make a really nice and smooth looking animation. Note again that almost every function that I use is done with a hotkey. These keys have ease out and ease in, but I don't need to spend the time to fix them manually. Instead, I will use the hotkey for automatic Bezier handles. The curves are already looking good with little effort. Now we can experiment with our spacing and play around to get different results. I can select multiple keys and use the favorite tool to quickly polish the curves. Store can help me out when experimenting. I can store the current curves, try something new, and then favor between the stored and the current curves. The favor tool has other modes that come in handy depending on the situation, but for now I will leave those for you to experiment with and I'll speed through polishing the rest of my curves. Thank you. The animation process can be very fast using the Favor tool, and I encourage you to try it with your pose-to-pose workflow. Soon, you will not be able to work without it. That I can guarantee. We'll have more videos for you soon. Until then, take care and happy animating.